Stroke is the term doctors use when a part of the brain is damaged because of a problem with blood flow. The word hemorrhage means bleeding. In a hemorrhagic stroke, a blood vessel in or on the brain starts bleeding. How can you tell if someone is having a stroke? Just think of the phrase BFAST. B stands for balance problems or dizziness. E stands for eye problems, if you have a sudden change in vision or if you're seeing double. F stands for face. Does the person's face look uneven or droop to one side? A stands for arm. Does the person have weakness or numbness in one or both arms? Does one arm drift down if the person tries to hold both arms out? S stands for speech. Is the person having trouble speaking? T stands for time. If you see any of these signs, call 911 or your local emergency number. You need to act fast and get to a hospital. Sometimes people get a severe headache that starts all of a sudden when they have a hemorrhagic stroke. How are hemorrhagic strokes treated? Doctors will do a CT scan or MRI that create pictures of the brain. They can show if there is bleeding in or around the brain. If the scan shows a hemorrhagic stroke, your doctor might give you medicines and other treatments to reduce brain damage. Your doctor might give you medicines to lower your blood pressure if your blood pressure is too high. Your doctor might also stop any medicines you take that thin the blood or prevent it from clotting. He or she might give you treatments to help your blood clot so that you stop bleeding. He or she may watch the pressure in your brain to make sure that it doesn't get too high. Doctors can do surgery to remove a collection of blood if it is pressing down on the brain or causing the brain to swell. Surgery can also stop the bleeding in the brain and fix blood vessels. Can hemorrhagic strokes be prevented? Sometimes, but not all the time. You can lower your chances of having a hemorrhagic stroke by getting treated for high blood pressure. This is very important because untreated high blood pressure is a common cause of hemorrhagic strokes. You can also reduce your chances by not smoking and not using illegal drugs. If an abnormal blood vessel was the cause of the stroke, surgery can sometimes be done to fix it and prevent it from bleeding again. What happens after a stroke? Some people recover from stroke without any long-term problems or with only minor problems. But many people have serious problems after a stroke. They might be unable to speak or feed themselves, or they might be unable to move one side of their body. People are also more likely to get other medical problems. This can include blood clots in the legs, heart problems, bed sores, or lung infections. Specialists such as physical therapists, occupational therapists, and speech specialists can help. Thank you for listening. Please like, subscribe to Diseases Simplified, and ring the bell for more health tips and updates.